No, they're never just bones. It's all part of history. It's all part of the world's history. Majority of people don't know we're here. And the facility, it's custom made to build dinosaurs. My name's Peter May, and I build dinosaur skeletons for museums throughout the world. I'm the owner, president of Research Casting International. We have 50,000 square feet. We can handle the biggest skeletons in the world. T-Rex, mastodons, allosaurs. We've mounted and displayed and built right around 800 skeletons. In our back room, we have 50 skeletons sitting in crates. When the skeleton arrives, it'll be uncrated, unpacked, and then it'll go into the conservation department. It'll be cleaned and hardened, and any of the old consolidants removed, so it's nice and strong. When it comes to the blacksmiths, they hammer out the armatures. Once all the armatures are done, then we go to mounting. All in all, there'll probably be about a crew of 10 that'll handle the fossil. We'll call ourselves the skeleton crew. We're doing a pair of skeletons right now, the dryptosaurs, and they're probably in one of the most dynamic poses you'll ever see. There's two dryptosaurs like leaping in the air, one on his back, one leaping down on top of it. We built the two big skeletons in the first movie, Jurassic Park, the rearing barosaur at the American Museum of Natural History. For the Smithsonian, we're helping them rebuild all their exhibits, all the fossil animal exhibits. Our job is to bring the old skeletons to life. I think when fossils arrive here, we become the caretaker. Nothing can happen to it. And every person who's handled along the way understands that responsibility. By the time it's finished, it comes out a much better fossil than when it arrived. When it goes on exhibit at the museum, it's going to last for another 100 years.